Welcome back to Scripps News Tonight, and a big warm welcome to Christian Bryant.
World peace!
I just learned about this, and you'll see it very soon.
I'm so excited.
It's from our next guest. Back in the 90s, Eurodance had this moment. I didn't even know the name of it, but it had a moment, and you know every lyric, you know every beat. It had a moment.
I remember the music videos. I mean, I was a big MTV, VH1, BET kids. So yeah. I remember all the music
like
videos.
Like Ace of Base and...
Ace of Base. We've talked about Aqua before.
Oh, yeah.
Ace of Base. They found success. Songs like the Macarena.
Macarena. I love
that. Remember how it goes.
Which, of course, I remember watching Hillary Clinton do it at that DNC. But, you know, Ace of Base, I still wondered, what is All That She Wants Is Another Baby? I didn't know, is it a baby? Is it a lover? Is it drugs? What is
you
it?
You remember the lyrics way better than I do. I just remember the way the music went. Yeah. Today, the genre is seeing a resurgence, believe it or not, from an unlikely source, TikTok. A parody of 90s Eurodance released by comedian Kyle Gordon in character as DJ Crazy Times has exploded in popularity for its broken English lyrics and infectious beat. Just take a listen. If you haven't heard it, take a listen.
We went with a little bit of a spicier lyric there than I thought we were going to.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, and it gets...
Women are my favorite guy.
Women are your favorite guy? Is that... The original video has nearly a million likes on TikTok in less than 3 weeks, and a full-length version, which Gordon dropped Tuesday, has over a million YouTube views in just 2 days.
Racking them up. It's won over celebrities, including comedian Amy Poehler and musical acts like the Jonas Brothers, who invited both Gordon and his dance partner, comedian Audrey Trulinger, perform Planet of the Bass live at a recent concert. Kyle Gordon, the creator of this viral phenomenon, joins us now. Kyle, what is up? How are you, my friend?
Great. Yeah. Thank you so much for having me. It's been crazy.
Of course.
I didn't know he looked like this. I only saw the video. I didn't know you looked like this.
Sorry, we're kind of taking it back because we're used to seeing DJ Crazy Time. And we're like, no, there's a real person behind this.
Okay, So we want to know more, right?
Yes, of course. I mean, I'm curious to know about what it feels like to take a song like this and take it from social media to a big stage
sold
with
out.
The Jonas Brothers. I mean, what is that like for you?
Yeah, it was completely insane. When I, first wrote this song a few months ago, I didn't write it like, oh yeah, the Jonas Brothers are gonna love this. You know, call them up, they're gonna have a blast. they reached out to me literally less than 24. We set that whole thing up literally like less than 24 hours before I actually went on stage. And before that, maybe the most amount of people I'd performed for was 400 in Brooklyn. So yeah, it was surreal.
Were you sober when you wrote the lyrics?
Yeah, 100%. English is my second language. You can't tell.
I do love the lyrics. This song, it kind of taps into, as I was listening to it, just letting it wash over me, kind of. It just taps into our nostalgia central nervous system, kind of. There's the floppy disk, the DJ who never quits talking during this song. There are the lyrics, touch it, make it twice before I cry. Heaven is a time today, which I agree. What elements were you trying to capture maybe when you were, taking us into our past?
Yeah, I mean, I think this particular genre of music, it was very popular in the 90s, obviously in Europe, but it would only ever kind of break through in the US every now and then. You know, it would kind of be these rare gems on American pop radio, like Aqua Barbie Girl or Blue Dabba Dee Dabba Die, Real McCoy Another Night. These are kind of every now and then we'd get these weird European songs that didn't quite sound like anything else on American radio. So I think that's maybe why, I have such a nostalgia for it, because it was these kind of beautiful, rare gems that you'd only ever hear on the radio every once in a while.
I forgot Yeah, it was just McCoy.
All vibes is what these.
I forgot about that. Another night and another.
See, I used to go to the skating rink all the time, so I'd hear these songs at the skating rink.
They're in your heart. Or you could buy them on Jock Jams and all of this.
Jock Jams. Yeah, take it back, man. I want to bring up the faux controversy online. Before the Planet of the Bass video dropped, people were on your head about the woman featured in the original video and then the rotating cast.
What does that mean, on your head?
On your head is like criticizing you. Okay. Like just kind of like they are on your head. Okay. Like just they are on you. You recorded all these around the same time, if I'm not mistaken. Were you sitting at home like, man, folks don't even know what's going to hit them. I'm going to bring it all back around to the original. I mean, what were you thinking then?
Yeah. So, for those who may not know, I recorded three different actresses lip syncing the lyrics to the video and released them sort of 1 week apart as separate promos for the video. And so I think the original idea was to sort of play on some of the tropes that are very specific to this genre, because, you know, a lot of times, especially in the early 90s, these European groups, they would record a song with an original singer, and then if it was a hit, they would just cast a random actress or model in the video and they didn't even care. And so I thought it would be funny to sort of play with that trope and have these different actresses lip syncing. But yeah, people really fell in love, understandably, because she's extremely talented and great actress. The video, the actress you see in that first video, Audrey, who's been so amazing. But I think all the actresses, you know, they're like the Powerpuff Girls. They each have their own like little vibe, and they all brought something different. But I think everyone learned a little bit more about Eurodance as a result of this whole thing.
There was a big scandal. Wasn't it Martha Wash or someone like that who had done this really amazing vocal, and then they just put this other model on it? Yeah.
Correct.
I remember that.
Taking us back. I love this.
I remember that. Can you tell it? I love the, I know, very talented, obviously, and very funny and gorgeous. She reminded me of Anna Kournikova, you know, like a gorgeous co-star of your video. Can you tell us about the making of the video? Because I was not expecting this production value. When we hear world peace and suddenly you're flying in the air, what was it like?
Yeah, this video, it was crazy because we had always scheduled, we shot that video last week. And so, editors, I have to give big credit to the production team and the editing team, Loose Films. They're based in Ohio, or as I call it online, Bratislava. Nice. But no, they're really based in Columbus, Ohio. And they are just like the most talented people. And they pretty much had like a 72-hour no sleep editing session. And they were able to finish it literally the midnight before we actually released it. But we were able to fly Audrey out to Ohio. And yeah, Loose Films, got to give them big credit. They are extremely, extremely talented. And I was very glad to have them help me make the video.
Very.
From Ohio to the world is what we've got. So this is a really important question here.
Aqua, we have a minute 30 left.
Oh yeah, Aqua is still performing Barbie Girl worldwide more than a quarter century later. Are you ready to take your heart into a unicorn for the rest of your life?
Yeah, why not? I mean, I'm having fun with it now. And speaking of, I actually saw, I'm based in New York, and I saw Aqua live about a month and a half ago before all of this. Like, I am a huge Aqua fan. So here, this is my opportunity to say, those who have not explored the entire Aqua catalog, you absolutely should. Roses Are Red, Lollipop, Dr. Jones, these are all fantastic masterpiece.
Canon. Deep cuts.
They're canon. Thank you for imploring us to do that for ourselves. No, this was super fun. When Roey, our producer, brought this to us, I'm not on TikTok. This is so good.
No, this is great. I saw the videos on Twitter, on Instagram. I was like, this is so good.
Congrats on the success. Kyle Gordon, comedian, actor, musical comedy extraordinaire. Kyle Gordon is great. Due out this fall, Kyle. Thank you so much. And your co-star. Tell her we loved her too, please.
Thank you. Will do.